Today's Mass is being offered for the welfare of the parishioners, for the soul of O'Neill Correa, for the soul of Timothy Gomes, for the souls of John, Monica, and Michael De Silva, for the soul of Mary Stanley Gomes, for the souls of Neville and Dorothy Pays. Thanksgiving to Saint Joachim, offered by Saint Joachim's Community, D Ward, and for pluri intentions.
I will never forget you, O my people. On the day of anguish, I will answer you. As you join in celebration, my joy will move among you. Be glad, O people of the earth. Lift up your heart with song and dance. For I am with you, yes, within you, forever. You work for others' freedom with a seed of hope within you. Hunger shall not harm you, nor thirst withdraw your courage. Be glad, O people of the earth, lift up your heart with song and dance, for I am with you, yes, within you, forever. You are the heart of my heart.
Name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today is 18th Sunday of the ordinary year, and on this day we celebrate Prison Ministry Sunday. The theme of Prison Ministry Sunday is prisoners should be integrated in the society through our help. As we celebrate Prison Ministry Sunday, my dear brothers and sisters, I'm reminded of Mahatma Gandhi, who used to say, "Don't hate criminals, hate crime." We today pray in a special way for our brothers and sisters who are behind the bars. Though some of them are innocent, for no fault of theirs, they are behind the bars. And there are the others who have been forced to follow certain evil practices. We pray for all of them that the Holy Spirit may guide them, protect them, and inspire them to realize their weakness and repent for their sins and come back to the society and get themselves integrated. We also pray for the families and society of these criminals, that they may accept them and help them to grow. My dear brothers and sisters, today we also celebrate this Mass in memory of late Father Stan Swamy, a Jesuit priest who was 51 years priest and was working for the rights of the Adivasis in Ranchi, Jharkhand. On the 5th of July, he had a custodial death. And the Jesuits are celebrating this day so that we may unitedly attain justice peace and harmony in the society. We pray for his souls, may his soul rest in peace. And now to participate in the Eucharistic celebration, let us call to mind our sins and ask God's pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us glorify the Lord by singing Gloria. Reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, the whole congregation of the people of Israel grumbled against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. And the people of Israel said to them, "Would that we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the meat pots and ate bread to the full. For you have brought us out into the wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Behold, I am about to rain bread from heaven for you. And the people shall go out and gather a day's portion every day, that I may test them whether they will walk in my law or not. I have heard the grumbling of the people of Israel. Say to them, at twilight you shall eat meat, and in the morning you shall be filled with bread. Then you shall know that I am the Lord your God. In the evening, quail came up and covered the camp. And when the dew had gone up, there was on the face of the wilderness a fine flake-like thing, fine as frost on the ground. When the people of Israel saw it, they said to one another, 'What is it?' For they did not know what it was. And Moses said to them, 'It is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brethren, this I say and testify in the Lord, that you must no longer walk as the Gentiles do, in the futility of their minds. But that is not the way you learned Christ, assuming that you have heard about him and were taught in him, as the truth is in Jesus, to put off your old self, which belongs to your former manner of life and is corrupt through deceitful desires, and to be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and to put on the new self, created after the likeness of God in true righteousness and holiness. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. word that comes from God. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, when the crowd saw that Jesus was not there, nor his disciples, they themselves got into the boats and went to Capernaum seeking Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the lake, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, you are seeking me not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures eternal life. The Son of Man will give it to you. For on him God the Father has set his seal." Then they said to him, "What must we do to be doing the works of God?" Jesus answered them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent." So they said to him, "Then what signs do you do, that we may see and believe you? What work do you perform?" "Our fathers ate the manna in the wilderness, and as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat." Jesus said to them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is he who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." They said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, as the part of your homily, we will now view a video sent by Father Gonsalves, the spiritual director of the prison ministry in the Archdiocese of Bombay. Let us view the video and pray for the members of the prison ministry.
A 7-year-old Matthew Albin is shocked to witness the lifeless body of his brutally murdered father. He grows up lonely and slips into the world of crime. A notorious assassin, Matthew becomes a threat to society and a challenge to the police department. But while incarcerated, Matthew is transformed through the intervention of the prison ministry. He is renewed in the love of Christ, reformed through rehabilitative efforts. And finally released from the bondage of crime.
Like Matthew Albin, thousands of reformed prisoners have been reintegrated into the mainstream of society. Are you ready to give them a second chance?
Prison ministry, reform to reintegrate.
Prison Ministry India, PMI, is an all-India voluntary organization working for the release, rehabilitation reformation, renewal, and reintegration of prisoners. It was founded in the year 1980 by Father Vargis Kariperi and Father Francis Kodian, who were then philosophy students at the St. Thomas Apostolic Seminary, Kerala. PMI, as a body, was formed in the year 1986, and PMI was officially recognized by the Catholic Bishop Conference of India, CBCI, in the year 2000. Since then, the second Sunday of August is celebrated as Prison Ministry Sunday in India, with the motto of "Be a love bomb, let it explode, not to kill, but to heal broken-hearted." I repeat, be a love bomb, let it explode, not to kill, but to heal broken-hearted. Archdiocese of Mumbai started prison ministry in the year 2001 under the title PMM, Prison Ministry Mumbai. Father Sebastian, the National Coordinator of Prison Ministry India, based at Bangalore, visited Mumbai in the early years of 2000 along with his team. His first stop was at St. Pie Church, Mulund. During Mass, he spoke about his ministry and its work in Bangalore and the other parts of South India. He drew their attention to the Mumbai prisons. Touched by what Father Sebastian shared, Father Rufus Pereira, the then parish priest of St. Pius, encouraged his parishioners to join the prison ministry. The Prison Ministry Mumbai works in 5 prisons in Mumbai: Arthur Road, Baikala, Kalyan, Taloja, Thane, and 2 remand home, also known as Children's Observation Home, Dongri, that is Umarkhadi, Manpur. Seeing the good works done by us, the government has approached us to work in yet another observation home at Matunga. This would not have been possible without the guidance and support of His Eminence, Oswald Cardinal Gracious, and Bishop in charge of the Prison Ministry, Bishop Alwin De Silva. Prison Ministry is a special call. Prison Ministry is a vocation. It is a call that demands commitment and sacrifice. Commitment to work each day to better the lives of the prisoners. At the same time, it is a call. A call to sacrifice our time, talents, and the resources that we have. As Jesus says in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 25, verse 36b, "I was in prison, and you visited me." When these words turn into action, we work towards establishing the kingdom of God here on earth. This is the ministry where service is rendered away from the public gaze. There is no media coverage, no live event to show on Instagram or Facebook, no photo opportunity to update one's WhatsApp status. Yet, we are excited to work because we experience God's loving presence in all that we do. Jesus reminds us in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 25, verse 40. "Whatsoever you do to the least of my brothers and sisters, you do unto me." My experience in this ministry has been that the volunteers are prepared to travel great length to help prisoners in their need. Today, we are blessed with 100 plus volunteers who are committed and dedicated. This commitment comes from prayer. The foundation of the prison ministry lies in prayer. Each unit is encouraged to have their own prayer group. Once a fortnight, they meet for intercessory prayer. During this lockdown, volunteers have been conducting intercessory prayer through social platform. The basic principles of Prison Ministry Mumbai, also known as RTHE, renew to release, release to rehabilitate, rehabilitate to reform, and reform to reintegrate. Renewal is a vital stage in the transformation of prison inmates. Many activities in prison and children homes help to bring about emotional, psychological, and social change and prepares them for release. Release of children and prisoners is possible with the help of God and willingness of lawyers and officials. Counseling therapy empowers them to step out into homes and society for rehabilitation. It is said, rehabilitate a prisoner today and have a joy of seeing new life blossom in rescued soul. I repeat, rehabilitate a prisoner today and have a joy of seeing new life blossom in a rescued soul. We have 20 established PMI rehabilitation centers around the country that caters to men, women, children, youth, foreign nationals, irrespective of community or creed, and help them to move into a life of reform. Reformation of ex-convicts has challenge. Volunteers reach out to our brothers and sisters, who in turn caution others to avoid life of crime. This leads towards a joyful process of reintegration.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Father, Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered upon Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. Descended into hell on the third day, he rose again from the dead. Ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Jesus is the bread of life. If we believe in him, we shall have eternal life. With confidence, we now place our petitions before the Lord, saying, your response shall be, Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
For the universal church, Lord, that your anointed ministers, Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and all consecrated people might be instruments of your liberating love. May they assist our brethren who are imprisoned in their journey of reintegration. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
For representatives of our government, Lord, you have chosen them to serve our country. During this pandemic, give them the grace to respond to the needs of our country with timely efforts of relief and restoration. Through your spirit of wisdom and compassion, guide them to recreate the life of people within the walls of the prison and beyond as well. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
for our brothers and sisters imprisoned, especially those wrongly accused. Lord, you who were innocent and falsely accused, understand their plight. They face physical, mental, and emotional persecution. We ask for your saving grace that the prison authorities and staff may be kind, gentle, and understanding towards them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
For the soul of Father Stan Swami, who offered his life in the service of the Dalits, tribals, poor, and marginalized in India, that his life and death may be an inspiration for others to follow in his footsteps and the footsteps of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
For all volunteers engaged in the prison ministry in Mumbai, Lord, you have called each one by name and they have answered your call to reach out to the least, the lost and the lonely in prison. Empower them in all their endeavors to be successful in the reintegration of prisoners. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our personal needs, the needs of our parish community, the needs of the prison ministry, Mumbai. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Loving Lord, we thank you for listening to our prayers. Stretch forth your comforting hands and touch all our brethren in prison. With the power of your Spirit, take us and use us for the reintegration of the inmates who are imprisoned. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness, we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may become acceptable to our Heavenly Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an external offerings to you. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundation of the world and have arranged the changing of times and season. You formed a man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and saints, we proclaim your glory, as without end we proclaim.
Who comes? comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and also Gracious, our Bishop, the auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a meaningful sign of peace. Peace with you. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Let us now make our spiritual communion. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Special announcements. At a meeting of the Cardinal with the Deans, it was decided that Holy Communion will be distributed to those who wish to receive communion after taking part in the online Mass. Holy Communion will be distributed by priests and assisted by the sisters and extraordinary ministers between 9 and 10 a.m. on Sundays only outside the Blessed Sacrament Chapel. Parishioners are expected to prepare themselves spiritually and receive communion reverently on their hands. Holy Communion will be distributed from Sunday, 8th of August. Having received Holy Communion, parishioners are requested not to talk and maintain an atmosphere of prayer and silence while leaving for home. August 7th, Saturday, is declared as the National Day of Prayer. We are all going through a very difficult time, and many of us are facing seriously challenging situations on account of the pandemic. With a view to pray for the departed souls and express solidarity with the grieving families and the communities, and to pray for the health of the world, the Conference of Catholic Bishops of India office bearers have resolved to hold a 1-hour national service, 1-hour national prayer service on Saturday, 7th of August from 8:30 to 9:30 p.m. The special prayer service with the Eucharistic benediction will be telecast on Catholic satellite television channels like Shalom TV, Goodness TV, and various other channels, and will be available on YouTube as well. Thursday, 4th of August, is the feast of Saint John Marie Vianney, the patron saint of priests serving in the parishes around the world. A special Eucharist will be celebrated on Sunday, 8th of August, to mark Vianney Sunday. We request you to kindly pray for your priests and make time to remember them in your family prayer. Friday, 6th of August, is the Feast of the Transfiguration of our Lord. Booking of Masses for the months of September and October is on Wednesday, 11th of August, from 9 a.m. onwards. End of the notices.
We now pray for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants and in controlling the spread of the pandemic. We pray that the vaccine be available for all our people, even the poor and those in rural areas. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord. Amen.
By the love with which you live, and the joy that overflows, you will be known as my disciples. In that love shall I abide. You shall follow my path. I am the way and the truth and the life. In that love shall I abide. By the love with which you live and the joy that overflows, you will be known as my disciples. In that love shall I abide. Those who keep my word shall have within them the one who sent me. In that love shall I abide. By the love with which you live,